Okay, so our group is a computational biophysics group. Basically, we do computer simulations to study how biomolecules self-assemble, aggregate, and form mesoscopic structures. Main area of research is understanding the organelle formation, how these clumps of biomolecules form inside cells. So we use molecular dynamic simulations with different resolutions, atomistic, coarse grain, to study these processes that happen in test tubes, inside cells. And we have collaborations with experimental groups to then confirm our findings. One of the most exciting studies that we've done is showing that we can generate vesicle-like architectures out of simple protein chains and RNA molecules. And this has been shown in our simulations and then later confirmed in the experiments done by our colleagues at University of Buffalo. Okay, so in our group, we don't do any experiments, which gives us a great deal of flexibility because then we can study many different systems, so we're not confined to any particular experimental instrument. So we design theoretical models on a piece of paper and then we implement them on a computer and then we simulate those systems, and then it's the job for our experimental colleagues to go and check if our crazy ideas were true or not. The problems we study is related to protein aggregation, and the misregulation of protein aggregation typically leads to neurodegenerative diseases such as Parkinson's disease, Alzheimer's disease, so aging-related diseases. So while we only focus on fundamental aspects of understanding the molecular interactions that lead to phase separation, aggregation of biomolecules, you know, this knowledge can also help people to counter these effects and possibly figure out ways to reverse aging or, you know, help people that suffer from these diseases. As a computational scientist, right, the work is always with you because you can always check your calculations, your simulations on the phone, you always have access to a computer, so you have to set boundaries. And this is an important skill that I try to teach graduate students, is find these blocks of time where you don't look at the computer, don't think about research, and try to enjoy life. Go exercise, walk, do your hobbies, but you basically you need a well-organized work-life balance in order to succeed in graduate school, and so that's a skill that people should work on. The kind of skills that students learn while working on computational projects is that they get they learn how to code, how to write scientific code, how to analyze data, how to do statistical tests of the data. So basically the skills that they learn can be applied to a wide range of industrial projects, and so it goes beyond computational chemistry, computational biology, and especially now in 21st century, well, we're being dominated by data, artificial intelligence, machine learning. I think these are very valuable skills going into the future. Yeah. Number one expectation is that students should be interested and motivated to do the research. I don't have any requirements in terms of background other than having a basic, having taken a basic course in physical chemistry or even biochemistry. So students in our group consist of they come from different programs, from biochemistry, molecular biology. Some of them haven't taken a math course in a while, and so I have a chemistry student. We have postdoc that has a physics degree, we have another postdoc that has bioengineering degree. So basically we have people that come from diverse backgrounds, and what unites all of them is the passion for the kind of problems that we study. I would say mix of both. So we're a very dynamic group where we have different personalities, and we try to maximize each of our strengths. So basically some people like to do completely hands-off, like they work independently and then they don't need my input, and then we also have new students that require a lot of guidance, a lot of hands-on help, a lot of discussions, in-person discussions. So I basically try to customize my approach depending on a personality. So there is no single approach. Yeah. You know, because of the nature of the research that we do, which is complex biomolecular systems, we really need experimental colleagues to verify our findings. And so most of our work is done in collaboration with one group, either in from Iowa State or from outside of Iowa State. So currently we collaborate with Vincenzo Venditti as when we study mesophilic and thermophilic enzyme dynamics. We collaborate with Julian Roche from BBMB program. We study disorder protein oligomerization. And then we have a very extensive collaboration with a group at University of Buffalo, where we together we study this protein nucleic acid phase separation. The best part of being ISU is my colleagues, it's the environment. I love everyone here. Basically, I've been in different schools, and I would say the environment at Iowa State is much more friendly, much more collaborative. I can just walk down and knock on the door and talk about some idea, and others feel free to do that, to do the same. And so I love it.